Welcome to Sunday Free For All. So what we thought we would do this morning, we're going to do something completely different. We did a series of videos last week that we have up on our YouTube channel, but I didn't post it to the Hair Curler Chronicles because it was all related to cryptocurrency and I wasn't sure how excited people were about that part of our journey. But I will tell you, I had major aha moments about the world of alternative coins and what's going on. So anyways, the bottom line is, it was really an eye-opening week for me anyways, learning about the world of altcoins and what's going on. And now I understand more about Ethereum and how Ethereum works and why it's so important and why people call it the new internet. I have a broader understanding of what's happening in the world around us. So it's sort of been a fun journey this week. And it's actually got me really super excited about the possibilities of the future. Well, were you excited about what we learned this week with Tim Perry?
I was intrigued.
Okay, you can't just say that and then
I just did.
I know, but that's okay. You were intrigued. You know what that reminds me of?
What?
I'm not gonna say. these one words. He's a man, a few words. And then my family wonders why I do all the talking.
I'm a man of few words.
No, it's not a chicken and it's a chicken and an egg conversation. Are you a man of few words because I do all the talking, or do I do all the talking because you're a man of few words?
I couldn't have put it better myself.
Well, which is it?
Yes.
Anyways, so.
Anyway, the trip that the hedge. The deflationary hedge that we chose back in
June last year
was Bitcoin. And Bitcoin is like one of those topics at a party that is like, you either like it or you don't. And most people have an opinion of Bitcoin without education behind it. And only from what they get from the media, which is fine. But the more we personally looked into Bitcoin, the more we saw it as a solution to the fiat currencies, to stocks and bonds. Now, don't get us wrong. We do have stocks and bonds. But as the year went on, you know, we watched YouTube University and Ethereum started to sort of get in my radar.
And I didn't understand Ethereum at all.
I still don't kind of. I mean, I do understand Ethereum because I've watched countless hours of different people, not just one flavor of Kool-Aid, if you will, about Ethereum. And so we started to focus. 100% still on the Bitcoin, but I started to buy little bits of Ethereum when it was down like $500, $600, whatever the case was. And but then recently we've been putting the channel together, putting the thoughts together and how do we progress? How do we expand? How do we grow the channel? Blah, blah, blah. And let's see, I guess Tim Perry had sort of picked up on what we were doing and it just sort of naturally evolved.
Well, he private messaged me. So there's been a lot of people that have private messaged me. I have been super excited about it for a long time, but I had that aha moment last week when we were with Tim Perry. And one of the things, do you remember back? I know I did this in a video that hasn't been posted yet, but I'll do it again because it's live. Do you remember those pictures that we used to have that it was maybe in the 1990s, which is going back a long time. And they were all the rage. They were super popular. They were
auto stereograms.
Is that what they were called? Auto stereograms?
And you know why I know that, folks, is because I'm editing a video right now that we had, and Nancy brings it up. So I thought, I'm going to look it up. And I think the best definition I've got is auto stereograms. It's like when you get all those dots and
they're squiggly, and stuff, and
if
squiggly
you
lines.
At it, you can see a Nephilim.
And everybody, you had to stand and stare at it, like stare at it. You had to cross your eyes to stare at it. And then once you got your eyes crossed in just the right way and you stepped back, all of a sudden a picture appeared where you couldn't see any before. Tim, I bought him 3 for his office and he said it was horrible. He thought I was putting him on for the longest time because he said if other people hadn't walked in the office and gone, oh, there's an elephant. He never once saw them. So he just thought I was putting them on, that there was, oh, look, there's an elephant in there, or oh, look, a field of flowers or whatever. But it's that whole thing about you all of a sudden put it in focus, step back, and a picture appears. That's what happened for me this week with the conversation with Tim Perry, because I didn't understand some things about what was going on in the world of crypto. And
some things?
A lot of things.
Everything.
Everything. You're absolutely right. So one of the things that I understand more now is why they call Ethereum the new internet. I didn't understand that before. And they're like, everything's being built on Ethereum and it's the smart contracts. And I'm like, I don't understand what they mean by that. We already have an internet. Why would we need another internet? Back when the internet first came out, I remember if I wanted to look something up on the internet, I went to a website called Ask Jeeves. And I was like blown away. You type in your question.
Did you ever get mail?
That's another thing. But, you know, you ask Jeeves, you could ask Jeeves anything. And then all of a sudden you get these miraculous answers. And I thought to myself, well, who needs the Encyclopedia Britannica? Now we got Ask Jeeves. We would never need anything else except for Ask Jeeves. Where is Ask Jeeves now? It's gone. It got replaced by Google. But as we were all using Ask Jeeves over here, what was happening was Google was in the background underneath everything, building their platform. So if you follow along with my theory, we're over here using this Ask Jeeves, and over here they're building this monster thing that we now all use as Google. Nobody goes to Ask Jeeves now. Nobody. Everybody Googles things. That's what they do. So where was Google before? It was being built by programmers on another form of the internet. And then when they were ready, they launched it. Well, that's my understanding of what's happening with Ethereum. So we use the internet as it is now. And then it goes, then they're building all the other structures. They're building all the other structures underneath everything on the Ethereum platform right now. So it's almost like
a highway.
Okay, but it's almost like you drive me crazy sometimes. But it's almost like if you knew, well, we were all using Ask Jeeves, and if you knew that Google was being built and you could buy into that concept as it was being built, knowing what it is today, would you have done it? That's the question. So if you can now go to today, and now we're looking at what's happening on the Ethereum network, and we're starting to investigate all the different platforms that are being built, and you, instead of buying it as a stock, you buy it as a token. And so the token is really funding the programmers who are building the platforms. So in the series that we posted on YouTube with my friend Tim Perry, that's explaining this all to us, he gave us his top 5 token picks, and I was so blown away, I couldn't sleep. I was like, okay, I'm now starting. That's what I'm saying, it's like that squiggly picture, that all of a sudden I've now seen the big picture. And once you see the big picture, you can walk by it and your eyes see the elephant every time. You unfortunately never did see the elephant or the lion or whatever I gave you in your office, which is sad. But you know what's funny? So now that guy, Ryan, that we met about, I feel like it's been, How 6 weeks ago, I guess.
End of Feb.
And I keep posting that he's got these live events on Sunday nights. So we are the guest speakers on Sunday nights. We're the crypto couple. I guess in a nutshell, the simplest way to think about this is there's too much stuff happening on Ethereum right now. There's just too much. So it's like there's a whole bunch of different smaller companies trying to build platforms on the background. Just like I said, just go back to the same example of Ask Jeeves is operating up here and then Google's down here preparing the ground. There's so many companies like Google preparing the future right now, and they're all on the Ethereum platform, which is slowing it down. So that's why they've had to charge these high fees to do it, even though there's some really, really, really life-changing opportunities out there. And the coins themselves are like pennies. But they are going to become our mainstay in the next 10 years. All these things that are being built on the background is what we're going to use on a day-to-day basis. And so, but there's a barrier. They've got some barriers up right now to participate. And so as this goes along, little by little, it gets easier and easier. And
there's 6,000 tokens, potential alt tokens, that are out floating around there. Over half of them run on the Ethereum chain to a certain extent.
And here's the other thing that's happening. As Bitcoin grows and gets a lot of notoriety, and I think it was it Goldman?
And it's on a separate blockchain.
It's on its own thing. So, and there's no fees to buy and sell.
There's mining fees.
Yeah, but not the same way that
there's no
Ethereum.
Gas fees.
There's no gas
fees to the, not even close to the extent of what Ethereum is charging.
Okay, so as Bitcoin rises in value and people start talking about it, what's going to happen is, and they become more and more and more comfortable with Bitcoin, all of a sudden because Bitcoin is so scarce and they're not going to be able to get it as much, they're going to start looking at all of the other cryptocurrencies out there. So it's like that thing about all, in a high tide, all the boats in the harbor will rise together. That's what they're predicting is going to happen. So even though I know it's been in the news recently that Bitcoin has taken a bit of a tumble, but it's going to go back up again.
Of course it is.
Because it's not never going to, it's, I would say it's never going to go back down to where it was last summer. I would be, maybe I'm wrong.
What price are you talking about?
$9,000.
It could very well. We don't know that.
I don't
go out and say that.
The
we
reason
don't know that.
I feel
it
like it's not going to though, Tim, is because like Goldman Sachs came out this week. It was in the Wall Street Journal. Goldman Sachs came out this week. It was Goldman Sachs telling their elite clients, their most elite clients, that they have to start taking a position in cryptocurrency. So
look at the adoption rate. Look at the adoption. Well, I mean, I don't think anyone here is as invested in it as us at this point in time, but we follow it and we see the adoption rate. I mean, heck, you know, PayPal's going to be using it. Cuban's using it. Heck, Mr. Wonderful Kevin O'Leary just put 3% of his, and don't kid yourself, he did come clean. He did come
he
clean
was
on
probably,
that interview.
He
you
was,
know, he came clean on that interview and said he's been dabbling in it since 2017. So, you know, of course he's Kevin O'Leary, you know.
Yeah. So it's a little bit of a performance as well.
Of course it is. If you watch us and you see what we're doing, you go and you look at the price of Bitcoin and you say, oh, it's at, I don't know, just for conversation's sake, oh, it's $50,000 US. And you know, you look and you go, to get into the game, you don't have to spend the $50,000 US. You can put in whatever you want to put in, you know. As I explained to people when we do our live chats or whatever the case is, if you put in $100, $500 or whatever the case is, and that 10Xs,
then now you got your 500s now 5,000.
Don't let the big price of one coin discourage you from getting it. We started with $300. $300 is what we started in.
And Tim made me feel guilty for that. He was like, well, it's gambling. I'm like, well, look, let's look at it like a nice dinner out. Aren't you glad we did that $300 instead of going out for dinner?
Well, we can't go out for dinner.
Well, that's true. But anyway,
but the point of the matter is that if you're intrigued by it and you want to see the process of it, and you think, ah, you know what, I got $50, $100, or whatever the case is, feel free to personal message us or call us and stuff. I can definitely walk you through a process of purchasing that and buying. Like right now, people go, I knew it was going to drop. I knew the price was going to drop, whether it be Ethereum, whether it be Bitcoin, whether it be these altcoins. And there's other people that say, what a time to buy.
Well, I mean, what's the example that they gave us? Remember when Amazon, remember when the tech bubble happened?
See, this is why I'm a man of few words.
Remember when the tech bubble happened and Amazon went like straight up like this and then it tanked down? Who wouldn't have wanted to get in on when it tanked right down? But then it jumped right back up and it has been high really more or less ever since. And that's why people go, oh, well, in 2017, Bitcoin tanked. Yeah, well, Amazon tanked after the tech bubble too. Like,
there are reasons behind the ebbs and flows of the price of anything.
Go ahead. There are ebbs and flows of everything. I was reading Scott's comments.
I know you were. How rude.
Oh, anyways, Bev and John, I hope they are good. Just being with people. I like you, but I miss being with people.
I had something important to say and you just shut me right down.
Okay, what I was...
Oh, no. No. People you want to know, you personal message me. I'll tell you what it was.
Oh, anyways, well, we've been 30 minutes. I didn't even think we had 5 minutes of something to talk about.
We got to go and do video.
Anyways, thank you. Thank you, Debbie, for sticking with us. Scott, Kim, Steve, Wilson, nice to see you. And none of you took me up on the, none of you took me up on the come on live. And so I'm going to try to do this next week. If you feel up to it and want to put your clothes on and your get your make.
If you have any interest about having $50, $100, I think some of them are a minimum $100 to open up the account. Okay. Well, if that's on your radar, just let me know.
Yeah. And block and honestly, and we love BlockFi because BlockFi earns you interest.
There are other platforms out there, folks, but our vehicle is BlockFi. I know it's American, but
it earns interest.
The reason why, I think one of the main reasons why we chose BlockFi is A, it was very, very highly recommended and it just made sense to Nancy. B, because our money can be held in U.S. funds in an American company. And eventually, we want to go south for 6 months of the year. So it kind of like made sense to do that. So that was our sort of rationale to a certain extent behind it. You have a different rationale. But all I'm saying is that you purchase the Bitcoin. When you purchase the Bitcoin, you can purchase or you can transfer the Bitcoin over to BlockFi. That's how you put it in and make money.
Yes.
Passive income.
Passive income so that I can get a Florida house.
Where else are you going to make 5%+ on an investment?
Yeah, exactly. Anyways, have a great day.
Bye, guys.